Hello and welcome, everyone. I'm Jennifer Bush, and I'm part of Vibia's communications team. We're so happy to have you all with us here. We have an impressive group from all over the world, and we hope you enjoy our special introduction to the Sticks collection. Before we begin, I just want to mention a few administrative notes. We ask that you please leave your camera and your mic in the off position. That'll improve the video quality and the experience for everyone. Also, we welcome questions. So at the bottom of your screen, you have a chat box and you could enter your questions in there along with your name and your affiliation, and we'll respond to those at the end. And finally, we're going to be recording today's webinar. So we'll send that to you afterwards and you'll have that as a reference. So let me start by introducing Arik Levy, who of course created our Sticks collection. Arik is world-renowned for his multidisciplinary designs, and he works out of his studio in Paris, as well as his studio in Provence, where he is today speaking with us. And Arik has a long history of collaborating with Vibia. Sticks is the most recent of the many iconic collections that he's created for us. So Arik, welcome to you. And I'd like to begin by asking you, what was the design idea for the Sticks collection? What was your brief?
Well, it's not a design idea. It's a concept. It's something that influences, in my opinion, the way light interacts with architecture and with people. And it started for me more as what can resemble the presence of the light without the presence of the fixture, or the fixture become art and become a sign in space.
Yeah.
Okay. I didn't want to create an object.
Yeah. And was it what the idea that seems so compelling is it connects space and planes in space and also disrupts space and planes in space. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, Sticks is the in my experience, the first system that connects wall to wall, wall to the space, wall to ceiling, ceiling to floor, floor to another wall. So that means that now we can connect the space in a different way that we used to. You come home, you put on the light, you either have a floor light or a table light on somewhere on the side, and you have a ceiling light hanging from the center. And that's now that all this is gone. Because yeah. I realized by testing that when we bring light to an unusual spaces, we actually open the physical parameters of the space and give it a lot more aura, gives it a lot more depth, give it the possibility to enhance other places in our environment that we don't normally see, because light is a transition through our life. You wake up in the morning every day, light comes from the window. It doesn't come from the ceiling. So the shadows react differently in our home. So the sense of perspective and depth, the way we receive it, is very different than what it is in the afternoon and in the evening. But these things we don't really think of. It's something that affects our psychology. And what Sticks does, it permits us to bring light into different spaces and places, all staying without its zero decorative, and it's 100% architecture.
Yeah. But it's quite beautiful when you see it, you have it behind you there. It is also quite beautiful when it's displayed in a space. It has an elegance to it.
Yeah, true. Elegance, beauty, sculptures, graphic, geometry, all these words are connecting to Sticks, and Sticks speaks this language. As you know, I have my artwork activity is very, very big. I'm a sculptor. This is how I started. And I join my artistic intentions into the products that I'm creating. And I would say the privilege of working with light and Vibia is that we are not there to to do a specific spot that lights in this many meters, that many lumens and so on, but we are creating light for the living spaces, for the living humans, especially now that we are spending more time at home, we can see how effective these things became, because before we just lit it up, lit it down, went to sleep, woke up in the morning, breakfast, get home, go to the, come back from the airport and so on. Now, suddenly every part and detail of our home becomes an essential element. So Sticks is doing this work. It also have an added function because it's not only linear. So the linearity is within the system where we run the red stripe and which were educated and tested, and we created a filter that creates a hum of light instead of a bright, something we can't deal with the eyes and have too much contrast. And that's the stick itself. And then what you do with it in space, it can become completely an abstracted contemporary sculpture, which is done by every one of the users, the owners, the architects, the interior architects. So it becomes a tool. We created a toolbox for everybody to express its creativity in a very free way.
I love that idea of a toolbox. It's and you can orient the light the way you need it for your, or the way you like the look of it for your particular space.
Yeah, so one thing is how you set it up on your plans and in space and how you see it. The second thing is how our intensity, so you know, we all of it can be dimmed or not dimmed, which is, I would say, common in lighting, but we added a function, and I will stand up doing it.
Please.
A function that doesn't really exist in any linear system. This is what it is. We can change completely the way the space feels just because we have turned the light around. So that can be done at any given moment and draw a different light intention. Of course, through the camera of the computer, the contrast is pushed because this is how these small cameras are, but it creates a fantastic halo on the wall itself and in space because the rebound with light is very effective to how the space behaves.
Yeah, and it has like a hybrid application as well, right? You can kind of play within the space that you live in. Can you talk a little bit about that? Its flexibility.
Flexibility lies in how you can use it as in fact you have the way the architect and the light designer would use it. This is one way. So you would create an object that when it's off, which is also very important, we tend to forget when the light, the object is off, it has to represent something. And if it doesn't represent anything, you don't really know what this thing is doing there, right? So when things are off, they have such a refined, sleek, elegant design, contemporary, almost, I would, if I would, you know, compare it to a car, it would be like, it would be an Audi, for example, and it would run through the space in a, with effortless, but at the same time with 100% or 1,000,000,000% performance.
Right. And
so when they are crossing each other, or we have 5 or 6 flying around, making a zigzag or being very geometrically correct, it all has a message. When you turn it on, then it's the second layer, and then you deal with it as a riposte of your feelings. I like a lot of light. I want an intimate light. I want to feel this way. I want to feel that way. And then comes the third layer, which is, as I mentioned, by rotating the sticks, you can have direct or indirect light, which is a huge difference. So if you want to work on your, if you work on your dinner table because you work at home, today you want to have a direct light. And when the evening comes and you have friends around or your family or whatever, and you have dinner, you want to have an indirect light because it's a lot more, there's a halo to it. It has more volume. It's softer. It's more caressing. People look more beautiful, which we all want to do. Feel like. So it's multifunctional. And mostly I want people to interact with the light. It's not something which is there and you don't touch it anymore. It's something that invites you to interact with, invites you to change the angles, I'm not going to do it right now, but the sticks are connected to the ceiling with a card system, like a joint, like a body joint, so it can go in any direction. And the floor pod is free. That means that you can rotate them like a compact in space and have them draw a complete, I can separate them completely, or I can have them cross more or cross less. And that at any given moment that you would like to do it and you're doing it, you are refreshing and renewing the way your living room looks, or your light fixture looks, or your installation looks.
Even in the fixed position that you have it, you can still adjust it and make it,
of course,
depending on,
And these adjustments are not improvement, they are changes. So it's the way, it's like the sun traveling through the space, right? During the day, it comes in the east and go all the way to west. And this changes are giving you a different feeling. Morning is morning, it's complete, sunrise is radically different than sunset in every possible way. Also in an emotional, psychological, and psychoanalytical way, which is part of light. No light, no shadow, no shadow, no perspective, no light, no life. It's everything which is into it.
Can you think of a sort of unusual application or an unusual place that maybe people in the past have not thought about placing light or installing a light that sticks, kind of solves that problem and it's perfect for, maybe in an unexpected way?
Yeah, absolutely. It's what I'm obsessed with the corners of a room.
Yes.
I'm the corner person. I'm like a spider going to the corner, looking to do this and connect in every possible way. And it's amazing how this, for example, this fixture here, which is a one single unit stick. Let me go back a little bit here.
Yeah.
So this single stick is a perfect thing. You put it has a base, which is about, say, a 12 centimeter diameter where the transformer is and so on. And then this you put right up front of the corner and you leave only the corner. Suddenly, the whole room gains 20 square meters. Wow. You can't sell it, unfortunately, as 20 square more, but it gains space, gains dimension, it gains a feeling, and it becomes, the more you use it this way, the better it becomes. And so at the other sticks, they can just lean on the wall or lean into the corner, and you can never put anything in the corner. So corners are, if you look at historical building, at the castles and so on, there was often a torch
exactly, yes.
You walk in a corridor and there would be a torch. Look at medieval films, for example. There would be a torch all the way, but there would be a torch in the corner because it represented the end of perspective. And this is what sticks is so good. It's so good about, and the way it is engineered permits you to take it anywhere you like in a very free way. So I feel that for the first time, light follows what we want it to do. We are not buying an object, plugging it in, and it stays there for 10 years. You know, you lift it, and then you have a trace on the table because the sun has tinted the wood, but not where the lamp is. You say, oh God, I haven't moved the lamp for 10 years, this kind of thing. So
yeah, the user is in charge of where they want to orient the light.
Exactly. And then there's a film that was, that influenced me a lot. I love science fiction in general, among others, but there's a film called Dune.
Yes.
Dune is a remarkable piece of cinema, and in Dune, when Muad'Dib is walking in the aisles, they have a light that floats in the air and follow them. So the light is not connected to the ceiling; it walks where you are, which makes sense, right?
Right.
Light when you are. You don't need the light where you're not. So, and for me, that was like a metaphor of how this, or a laser beam, or a shooting star. It's just this thing that crosses the space and leave the trace of what it is. And literally if you see this, what's on the wall, when it is to the wall, you just see, you see a shadow actually.
Right.
So the shadows produces light, which I think it's a poetically, it's a quite absolutely a beautiful, it's in a beautiful aspect of what light represents to me.
Yeah, and this idea that you were talking about how you gain space with the light, it's such an unusual way to look at it.
We're so used to the light coming from the center. So yeah, drops shadows vertically down, right? So what happens, you're standing there, you have the light hits your eyebrows, your forehead bone, that casts shadows on your eyes, which is not great, right? But you want a rebound of light. So when light starts to come from vertical surfaces instead of from horizontal or vertical, from top to the bottom, then you have light rays traveling the space in very different angles. And that creates a halo instead of creating a direction. And I think it's far more interesting for us. And also the dimensions of sticks is so reduced to the minimum possible that you can really slide it in between into a very small space, and it will still be not only effective, but also present in its own way, like an architectural detail instead of an aesthetic object that you say, you know, this light after 5 years or 10 years, you're not gonna say, oh, or 6 months, I don't like it anymore. It's like, you know, you buy a table and the first 2 weeks you tell it, all your friends that you bought a table and it's so nice and you wanted it for so long and so on and so on. So on. 6 months later, and you have a succession of dinners, so everybody see the table and so on. No? And then 6 months later, you have less dinners and you eat a different table, put the table nap because it's not new anymore. And 3 years later, you give it to your sons because you just moved into a new apartment and so on. So, and so it loses its, it's not anymore the star. This idea about light and about how sticks are behaving in space is beyond the object.
Yeah, wow. Did it in the end, was it what you first thought it would be when you and Vibia conceptualized it? In the end, did it take a different path than what you originally conceived of?
It's normally me and Vibia. It's a love affair. It's not a client. I'm not a designer. They're not a client. We are family. We first discuss the possibility. Everything is like a Christmas dinner, you know. We fight, we agree, we disagree, we love each other, we hug, we don't agree, then suddenly we don't want this and we don't want that. So we're actually doing a circle.
Yes.
Round. Sometimes it's like blah, blah, blah. Sometimes it's like this. And then we always come back to this. I'm not interested in creating something that doesn't have a self center. It's like a handstand in yoga. You don't have your legs somewhere else. If you are not axed, and if you are not parallel, and if you are not centered, you cannot stay in balance. You have to apply so many muscles that you are not in asana, that you are not in a relaxed place. And that's what I want. I want what we do to be something that talks to people in an open channel. It's not something that you have to convince yourself to get. It's something that you want to have. So it's a desire. It's not only a need.
And what do you think, why do you think it's so successful working with Vibia, that you have this openness and you can discuss it and you can go around and evolve in the circle? What do you think there's something that, the secret to the success of the collaboration?
There's no one answer to this. I think the secret to the success is the open-minded. Is an open-minded process. It's the process. It's not the beginning and it's not the end. It's the process that makes it successful, because we keep on asking, and I'm the guy who says, what's wrong? Okay, look, we made the prototype. I say, okay, what's wrong in it? And I'm looking for what's wrong. Sometimes nothing is wrong, so I invent. Or it makes me do something else. Say, hey, you know, if we take this, we put it upside down, we connect it this way, then another model is born, which is often the case. So we actually run pretty fast through the conceptual phase. And also I'm very experimental. I like hands-on. I email before I come and say, I need this tool. I want that many sticks. And we had, I don't know how many sticks in the workshop. We were holding it. It was falling from every direction. Because we had no connection. We had nothing. In the beginning, it was only a piece of wood painted. It was great because we really moved into the project and moved the project into its final stage as we go. And then it's always a very intense days we're working maybe 14 hours and it goes off like in a second, which is a reference to something that really works. Everybody is into it, creative. There isn't a stupid idea. There isn't a stupid comment. It's like an open space.
And right.
We are cracking, laughing on the floor. We are traveling in intimate spaces. We are having a great time, and design is not only design, is problem solving first.
Yes, of course.
Improving everyday's life in a 1%, 10%, 50%, whatever. Making the industry better. Giving people options to choose from, not to stuck to one thing. Improve every phase of production, making it sustainable is a big word, but what you have to do is you have to physically do it. You have to bring a product which has great performance, which has a great image, great vision, and a great price, because what you want people to use it. And the more it becomes unique and special. And this is what is really special at Sticks. It is sometimes it's too complicated with a product that has a very strong identity. So if you make a product that has a very strong visual identity and it's one thing and it's always the same. So if you have a restaurant and in the other side of the street at the end of the road, there's a restaurant that used it, even if you love it, you're not going to use it because you don't want to look alike.
Right.
We are all individuals. So this concept is one of unique concepts that adapts to the user and not the user adapts to people. So
it's very powerful. We have some questions. I think people want to know even more detail about how it works. The first question is from Edward Brink, and he asks, Can we see some of the details, such as the base and the part where you connect two sticks? I don't know, with the way you have it set up there, Arik, is that possible to show the base?
Well, I have the base of the single one is just here next to me. And I'm gonna turn it.
Okay.
Turn this. Up. That's the base.
Okay. Great.
Comes around. In the middle of the base, there is the dimmer. So you can press it and have the light adjusting the way you want it. So it's very easy. Now dim down.
It's very easy.
It's easy. It's very fine detail. The detail of the hanging system is difficult for me to show because I don't have any hanging fixture here.
Yeah.
Right, but on the website, on our product presentation, there's all the details. It's actually the cable is attached with a very refined, beautifully designed, simple to execute connecting to the ceiling. There's a super, super thin cable, the thinnest you can have, with having security connected to a little arm in steel with a ball joint that goes into the end of the sticks and permit the rotation this way and that way. So it's like a cardan on a mast of a windsurfer somehow. So it permits you to move the light to the direction you want. So we have a great flexibility in terms of the geometry of the entire installation.
Okay, we have another question from Diego Correa. He said he's an interior designer. He asks, he says, how the light is connected to this, how is the light connected to the socket? And because the light is very architectural, it becomes kind of like a sculpture and it needs space. Was it your intention to design an elegant imposition? I think he means, what was your intention to design something that was elegant? And because it's so clearly elegant, it seems like it was that your primary goal? I don't think so, primary, right?
No, there isn't, as I said, there isn't first or second or third. I mean, in a design process, the goal is, as I mentioned before, to make an intelligent product, to bring it to the market in the best quality, to solve problems, to make it a price available, and so on and so. But the design itself, as I'm obsessed with aesthetics of perfection, not decoration, but of perfection. And if anyone log into my website or my Instagram and so on and look at the artwork, you can see that how the pieces are done and how they are created to have a perfected form into them. So I'm striving to have, I'm also starving soon, but to have this perfection and this elegance. Is what is tricky in this type of design, when you make a system that I don't want it to look like a system, but it behaves like a system. So it doesn't have a modular aspect to it. It has a flexible aspect to it, right? Which is very important, because flexibility is everything about the future, and modularity is everything about the past, because a fractal can only fit its own self.
Right.
But with the flexibility, you can do a lot. So we have only three sticks, and with these three lengths of sticks, you can compose endless amount of composition. And what's beautiful in this for me is that someone who is getting the sticks in their hands and would like to play with it in space or on the wall or on the floor, or wherever you want to do it, gets his own self and personal composition. So when we do that, we appropriate psychologically and physically, we appropriate the object. And the object becomes, that's what I call the toolbox. So the final result of any sticks installed is the result of the creativity of the person that has designed the installation or installed it, choose how to install it. And I think this is where the elegance of the sticks, the fact that they are distilled to the strictly minimum, permits everybody to play with that and create his own language. If you take two of them and put them together and attach it with a piece of rubber or cord, like a teepee, like an Indian tent, that would be great. And you know, nobody, there's no rules. Our rule is to permit people to use this element safely and and create the light they will promise to get, and having it behave the way they want to behave. And this is
a powerful tool.
Yeah, and elegance is part of this. Elegance is in performance. Elegance is in the form, but since it doesn't have a form, the elegance is how this form is put into. There is a very important exercise one can do. I did. You take a block of post-it, right? And then you take a pen and you put your name, and you can put it in 100 different places. You put everything on the wall. There's only gonna be very few of them, maybe 3 or 4, that's gonna work very well. Work very well means it's gonna look good. It's gonna be in the right proportion. It's gonna be in the right position. It's gonna express something. It's gonna give this piece of paper space and so on. And it is the same, is how to deal with that in this way.
And we have a lot of questions coming in now. What Albert Niebot asks, what makes the product different from other lighting products available? And also he asks, what was the most challenging aspect of making this product?
Well, Albert, what makes it different is that it is solving a number of problems in a flexible way rather than one problem in a modular way. So if you look at many linear products today, and I'm not here to make judgments about other products that exist, I'm only here to talk about my own product, is that but linear systems like the classic track system that we used to have on the ceiling, is that we could not move things, and they were done to behave 90 degrees, and we cannot do things in a different way. So this system does it. There's no system that goes from the wall vertically, horizontally, to the space, to the ceiling, as in intended design with design and geometry and mechanical solutions to it. This does not exist. And there isn't any other system in the market that once you install it, and it has a complex transition between the axis of Y, Z, and X, that you can rotate each one of them individually and get a different effect. If you put all these together, there's nothing like this in the market.
Yeah. And somebody asked, it seems like it would be great. Edward Brink asked, Sticks seems like it would be great for outdoor use as well. Is there an outdoor version
I cannot agree more. I run around with my sticks in the garden outside. I think it's going to be an amazing. This is something that we are discussing. We first had to put the system for indoor and have people understand the system and want to use it. We have shown in Frankfurt, I think, 2 years ago, when fairs were still something that people did. Because it was possible. Yeah. We showed an intention of the sticks as if it was running between walls outdoor without saying it's outdoors, because it has not engineered yet to outdoor. Outdoor has a huge amount of other technical limitations that we have to overcome. I don't think that is a major problem to do it, but of course it's another big transition. It turns to a huge program. And hopefully it will come. It will come. It's only a question of time. That's the thought. There isn't more satisfying feeling than taking this kind of fixture into the outdoor and live with it. And thank you. I mean, I want to do, I just picked up the olives of my olive trees and squeeze them. So I made my first olive oil this year, and which was an exciting thing. So I was spending time like a monkey in the trees to pick up all the olive and not miss any of them. But while I'm doing that, I'm thinking, wow, imagine the tree having three or four sticks, or you have maybe 5 or 10 trees and each one has a stick, light stick like this, going from any direction, and your garden turns into paradise at night. It's different. So,
yes. So you're already thinking about it.
Yes.
Okay, great. Patrick Collins asks, are you considering using tunable light versions?
A what light version?
Tunable white. Dimmable is what.
Yes, they are all dimmable. This is dimmed down. Dim up, I can do the other one. Look at the wall. There we go.
Down, right.
Off, up. Yeah, this is the theater of life. Everything is possible.
That's great. And Ruan with Anage says, can you customize according to the project requirements? And I think that's the beauty of it. You can 100% customize, right?
Now that is an interesting subject, because customization is a key to individuality, right? That's what we are, all individuals. So makeup, there's nothing more customizable for face than makeup. You know, each one right. in a different way. There's a billion colors. You can do it this way, this way, this way, this way. And then clothing. So we can buy the same amount of clothing in the same shop, but we will probably use them differently. So the light, the way we customize, which gives us a great advantage is what we mentioned before, endless amount of angles. So
yes.
you and 100 other light designers or interior designers, or what is your function, architect, can have the same amount of three sticks, and each one of them is going to do a completely different thing, and they're all going to look different just because of right. the composition, because sticks is an alphabet. The alphabet has 22 or 24 symbols. It depends which country you are, what language you speak, and so on. And then you can compose with it endless amount of books. Look how many words I said, and they'll all be with 22 letters, right? And this is sticks. Stick is, so it's a toolbox again. It's
the building blocks.
Reduced, it's distilled to the most synthetic possible ever component to permit you exactly to compose it. Then we have the three different sticks, 1 meter, 50, 2 meter, 3 meter. And with them, with this combination of three dimensions and rotation and endless amount of angles and surface to wall to ceiling to floor to room, I don't see how you cannot customize it.
And Janto Viharja asks, can the intensity of light be controlled from your mobile by an app, or can you change the color? That's a great question.
Yeah, this is it's desirable. I mean, this is the Blade Runner film effect. You come home and you say, music, light, toaster, whatever. So Alexa is already doing part of it. And also I don't know if I want to get used to this, but to control, it's to do with the domotique, with the general system in the house. Because if you install a module in every light fixture, it's going to be so expensive. Well, 99% of the people will not use it, or 95. So, and it will make the product expensive for all these people because of 5% are using it. So I think in the near future, and in specific installations where the different fixtures are connected to a full control, for example, a villa or apartment or a new building, then they might have the system already installed, and then yes, you can control it, like we can control the door handle or your car or anything else. So it's an existing technology. The question is only where does it make sense in terms of its cost efficiency and the cost of the product. So say, just for an example, if this costs €300 and to have it controlled from the phone will make it €700, maybe it doesn't make sense. Maybe a remote control would make more sense, and so on, because the phone has to talk to the Bluetooth or to the Wi-Fi and so on. But it's I totally agree with the need or with the wanting of it. And I think that in very little time, everything we have at home will be controlled from the phone or from a similar tool.
Yeah, from an app. And is there something called Kasambi?
Yes.
The smart dimming, right?
Yeah, there's Kasambi, there's Domotik, there's many different systems. Of course, the big companies that are developing this, everybody is fighting everybody. Who gonna have or which digital language the system should talk? Yeah. And I remember,
Sticks is compatible with Kasambi.
Yeah, it is definitely. So as I said, it's connect, but the individual has to either the system is there, so it connects to it.
Yes.
Or it's not each element carrying the whole system. So one on one. Yeah.
And Bina Patre asks, can sticks be pre-charged, or does it need a constant power supply?
It's not on battery. It's not a portable light yet. It doesn't really have the function because you don't walk around with it. So it's not a takeaway or a carry on. It is connected to and as you can see, it's very powerful. So you can have it when it's dimmed, you say, hey, it doesn't need a lot of power, but when it's full power, it's very strong light, which is great because you can have the light with it to make plastic surgery almost in a sort of stick or make a very intimate dinner. So this is the range of sticks, which is very important. So yes, it is socket connected. Maybe we're gonna make a micro stick that big that you can put on the table outdoor when you have dinner.
And tell me the three lengths now. Bina Petra is asking also, what are the lengths? You referenced how long they are. Can you say again each of the three sticks, how long they are?
Yes, if I'm not wrong, it's 150, 2 meter, and 3 meter. Or is it?
Okay.
Something like this. I can't recall exactly, but this is the right thing. And then so you can make up to 6.5 meter linear on one power unit. It's an important question in that sense, that you can go 6.5 meter, which is pretty long. So you can create a form, or you can go wall to ceiling, to wall to wall, ceiling to floor, and using one power unit means that installation wise, we don't have to have three power units, three connections to the electricity, a mainframe, and so on and so. So you have one connection to 6.5 meters, and however you compose it, and they have a little plug and play, like a little socket plug of headphones when you connect them one to the other.
The question, when I was asking you about tunable, Edward Brink actually texted again another question. He was asking about controlling the color temperature. Can you do from 1800 to 3000? Can you do that with this? Can you adjust that, the color temperature?
We have, if I'm not wrong, there's three Kelvin levels. I don't remember exactly. It's something like 2, 3, and 4,000. If I'm not wrong, or 2005. So it's more warm, and then it gets colder. It depends on the use. It depends on the space. It depends where you are with it. To have a complete control on the color temperature implies that you have to have a different kind of LED system, which is more expensive, and then you don't have only an on-off and dimming button. Then you have an on-off dimming and color temperature, and so it becomes again over-engineered. Which is the case of many, many products today. I design many different products, not only lighting, but the desire to over-sophisticate and over-engineer a tool brings its price to a level that it makes it unaffordable, especially that we are not using it. So take a very easy example. Statistically, we know that we probably use only 5% of the capacity of any laptop computer we have at home and at work.
Yeah.
5%. And we pay the full price because each of the manufacturers says, oh, you know, you can do this and this and this. So we give you all the options. But, you know, if I look at myself, I email, I do some Photoshop and maybe Illustrator, a little bit of 3D, and that's it. I mean, I'm not like, my computer is not standing there calculating billions of elements 24 hours a day. We look at the telephone. How much function we have and what do? We text, we talk, and we do some emails. So some people more than other, I'm talking about majority. I work with these tools intensively, so maybe I have it's more efficient in my hand than it is efficient in my father's hand or in somebody who's running a business that doesn't really need. So somebody who has a simpler business, doesn't need the sophistication of the phone, but it has the same phone and costs the same. So I think adjusting giving the possibility. And also when we design a product, when we engineer a product to the market, it's not only me and the engineering development team, which are all fantastic people that are making my dreams come alive at Vibia. It's not us sitting around the table say, hey, let's make it this and let's make it that, because we are having feedback from the market. We are collecting since years. We are talking to thousands of people nonstop, looking at I'm going through from shop to shop, listening to how things are discussed. I'm talking to architects nonstop in projects which are only going to come through maybe in 2 years or 5 years and so on, to understand what is needed and how it is used. And then in every product, and I think every working professional in whatever field, it doesn't matter if you're a baker or a designer or a professional bike rider, you go in diagonal in your Excel sheet and say, okay, how much? What do I have to give and what do I get? And this is a very fine balance of things. And, yeah. And you know, when you buy a ball bearing that costs something and another one that costs something else, and one is rolling forever and the other is rolling and it goes like, at the end, then you know. So it has technology and quality often, not in everything, but often has a direct relation to what it costs to make. And yes, we live that every day. It doesn't matter if it's your fruits or it's your gasoline. Yeah, it's a cheaper gasoline, but it's not refined as much. Or it has, or the price became too high because there's over marketing there, but I'm not talking about this. I'm talking about, you can buy a screwdriver and you can buy a screwdriver. The one that costs €2 and the one who costs not 17 euros, but maybe the car that costs 7, that comes from companies. And you also have to be a responsible consumer to make a research. And also, I don't want to say to mention any companies because it's not the point, but there are companies that are dedicated to what they do, not to marketing, dedicated to the product. And therefore, they would put all the possible effort to make the product, to bring the product to such a level that it represents what they're asking for as for its price. And it makes no sense to any industrialist to create something that doesn't hold the price he is asking for.
And I just confirmed that the LED color temperatures, it's available in our 2700, 3000 and 4000 Kelvin. So just, somebody else asked, Diddy Neuron wants to know if you can change the number of fixtures that you have. So let's say you have an installation of two, can you connect an extra one at any time, right?
As long as you don't pass 6.5 meter for power unit. So say you bought 1 meter 50 and 2 meter, right? So you have a 3 meter 50 installation. Then you change apartment or office or whatever, or you would like to continue another 2 meters. You buy the another 2 meter stick and you connect it and that's it. So This is what's so great in this. It is flexible and it is evolutive. You can, so imagine also a space or an office space, maybe they have, or a restaurant with 5 different rooms. And then a year or 2 years later, you want to facelift the whole space. You take all the amount of sticks and you compose something completely different with it. It will look different and you're still using the same amount of sticks. I hate in any possible way throwing things away from the window. Throwing money away from the window in sense of making things which are not useful, making packaging that doesn't really optimize the shipping, the size, the security, making product that you cannot optimize and use long term. Look, we all looking and we say, oh, that's great, it's vintage.
Yeah. Okay?
There's a big period in our life. I'm born 63. So in my life, there's a huge period where products do not last because they were not well made, because They were not well thought, because nobody wants them. So all we look at the 40s, the 50s, you know, some a little bit from the 70s because it's funny, 80s, 90s. I don't know if I want to keep anything from there, or I can't keep it. It was the beginning of, not that there's not progress, it's progress. So the first Walkman you had was made in China, you wouldn't have the possibility to change the batteries. It will fall apart before. Of course, now all the best stuff is or most of the best stuff is down there. So there's progress, and progress is something that Homo sapiens, human beings are doing it very well. This is why we are who we are, we do what we do, we manage what we manage. We also a crazy conqueror, so we don't manage other things like the planet, like the ecology, like all these things. And I'm screaming against this. So if we can make in Vibia the packaging of sticks 2 centimeters shorter and keep still the fixture safe and easy to unpack and so on, we will do it, because 2 centimeters, it sounds like nothing. But when you multiply it by the linear meter of cardboard used and the number of trees you have to cut to make this cardboard, then you say, oh, this is our mission. We have to save at any level. So it connects to this question of, can you evolve? And evolution is this, is to be able to evolve and still gives pleasure and beauty and elegance and renew what you have in your hand without feeling that you are just, you know, standing in place.
Yeah, quality is timeless.
Absolutely.
And if you could describe, just we don't have too much more time, but if you could, Andrea Requena had a question. If you could describe the product with 3 words, what would those 3 words be?
So elegance is definitely one.
Yes.
Something went off in the studio. The general lighting went off. I would say it is flexibility, elegance, and performance.
Flexibility, elegance, and performance. Yes, that's a good summary of it. Is there anything we haven't asked you about?
The tree, you can compose many different things.
Yeah. Is there anything we haven't touched on that you think is important for the participants to know about?
Well, I can speak now for 24 days. I'd love doing it. But I think, yes, there's one thing we haven't touched, which is having the thing in your hand. So we live in a digital era, and more than ever now during this pandemic thing. But having it, so to give everyone this, the door to creativity with sticks or many other things. So take 3 chopsticks or 3 pieces of sticks from the forest and just have them in your hand or on the table and play with them. This is exactly what sticks is doing. And then when you've done your composition and you're happy with it, add in your mind the light. And from that, and the third thing you do is you call Vibia.
Absolutely. And then you called Vibia, and I want to encourage everybody also to look on Vibia's website under Lighting Toolkit Sticks.
Oh yeah, that's something. I don't know how many of you are connected to this, but Vibia has developed a creative platform many years ago that is only getting better. And what's really great in it, because we are talking about fully flexible, adaptable, adjustable, like my other system, Wireflow or Rhythm. You go into this platform, and in the platform, you have all the choices of the different compositions. So you either place this in the space you are designing, or you take elements and play them. And once you finish that, you press the button and you have the plot of everything you need. And this is for architects, for designers, for interior designers, for light designers, an amazing thing, because we used to sit, I also do interiors and so on, we used to sit with hundreds of catalogs trying to compare this page and that page and what kind of plugin, what kind of thing, and which dimmer, and blah, 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 and it was a nightmare. So Vibia actually integrated the creative process of their users, which is in many cases the interior designers, architects, light designers, into their product. And when we design, when we have our talks, and when we have our push and pull for and against, we talk about this. We say, okay, great product. How do we give this the push into the platform so everybody can use it in their own way and create what they want? So yes, that's definitely a great thing.
That's great. Well, Arik, thank you so much. This was so helpful. And thank you to everybody who joined with us today. And as I said, you can find more information on the Vibia website under Lighting Toolkits Sticks. And contact Vibia with additional questions. But thank you so much, Arik.
Yeah, thank you, Jennifer. Thank you, everybody. I don't see any of you, but I know you're there. So it's beyond my control. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Okay.